the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us for a moment join our hands and close our eyes. And let us remember this promise of the Lord from the book of Leviticus, chapter 26, verse 11. God is telling, I will place my dwelling in your midst. I will place my dwelling in your midst, and I shall not abhor you. I'm going to walk among you, and you are going to be my people. Let us remember this promise of the Lord. God says, He is going to walk among us and make us His own people. He places His dwelling among us. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 4, verse 7, we read, the Word of God is telling, For what other great nation has a God who is so near to His people? What other great nation has a God who is so near to His people as our Lord is whenever we call on to Him? As we're going to celebrate the sacrifice of our Lord Jesus, He promises us He is a God who is among us, who is so near to us. Let us thank His presence amidst us in the Holy Eucharist that He is going to give us in His own body and blood. At this moment, let us also admit all our failures, maybe a failure in thought, in word. Let us acknowledge every small failure at this moment as we are going to celebrate His holy sacrifice. Word of God is reminding us in 2 Corinthians, our competence does not come from ourselves, but our competence is from our God. It is our God who gives us the competence, the worthiness to come into His presence. Let us acknowledge His mercy in our life. And let us say together,
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Christ have mercy on us all.
And mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Ephesians, chapter 3, verses 14 to 19. For this reason I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that he may grant you in accord with the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with power through his Spirit in the inner self, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, rooted and grounded in love, may have strength to comprehend with all the holy ones what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. This is the word of the Lord.
Can you stand for the Gospel Acclamation?
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Chapter 19, verses 3 onwards. Some Pharisees came to him, and to test him they asked, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for any cause?" He answered, "Have you not read that the one who made them at the beginning made them male and female? And said, for this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore what God has joined together, let no one separate." They said to him, "Why then did Moses command us to give a certificate of dismissal and to divorce her?" He said to them, "It was because you were so hard-hearted that Moses allowed you to divorce your wives, but from the beginning it was not so. And I say to you, whoever divorces his wife except for unchastity and marries another commits adultery." His disciples said to him, "If such is the case of a man with his wife, it is better not to marry." But he said to them, "Not everyone can accept this teaching, but only those to whom it is given." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord, all for you, everything I give to you. All for you, Lord, all for you, make it all your own. Take my hands and feet, Lord. Everything I give.
brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept his sacrifice at your hands for the faith and glory of his name, for our good and the Father's holy church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you blessed the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the Father. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the Son. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the Spirit. Hosanna, 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 Holy One.
Fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Die, you destroyed our death. Rise, you restored our love. Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope Francis and our Major Archbishop George and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, let us dare to say the prayer our Lord taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be against us, do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days,
that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant
the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
the Lord. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door to me, I will enter his house and dine with him and he with me. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those who have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended, and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.